Okay. Without any further ado, we're going to bring the mighty man of God up.
Amen.
So that he might plant some seeds into the hearts of God's people, that they might be able to glorify him even more. My good friend, dynamic speaker, pastor, Dr. Gerald Peavy.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. One more time.
Amen.
Let's say amen before I bring the word of God. I want to thank God for Pastor Harold Stanley and Sister Stanley. I met Dr. Stanley through Papa Charlie and Dr. Rosemother, Anita Rosemother. And when they brought him here, I connected with him as soon as he stepped in the room. Now, let me just say this right quick. Scary folks will get you killed. And God told everybody in the Bible that was scary to go back home. The Bible said that the righteous is bold as a lion, but the wicked man flee. Somebody know that Bible. When no man pursue. I'm trying to turn to somebody and say, scary quick to get you hurt. I'm trying to tell you, they'll run off and leave you by yourself. They'll turn and stay there when it's on you. I'm going to tell you right quick by standing. Watch it here. Jesus said it was my own familiar friend that lifted up his heel against me. This is what he said. He said, if it would have been an enemy, I could have dealt with it.
Yeah, come on now.
Then he said, it was a friend that I went to church with.
Yes.
He said, but if it would have been an enemy, I could have dealt with it.
Yes.
How many of y'all been hurt by a friend? Jesus said, that is a friend. That stick is closer than a brother. Jesus said, I no longer call you servant, but friend. The Bible said, in order to have friend, one must show you. But you need to let God be your friend. Watch it feel like quick. When David did the 23rd Psalm, watch what he say. He say, he leads me in the path of righteousness. God gonna put people in your life that have your best interests at heart. He leads you in the path where other folks love God. He put them in the path, you young women, all these people that got that gold in their mouth. God ain't gave you nobody like that. David say, he leads me in the path of righteousness. Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Going around here drinking the baby milk, eating up all the food. Amen, Wall. The Bible says if a man don't work, he don't eat.
Amen.
You ought to let his belly beat his backbone. Amen, Wall. A man's supposed to take care of his home. If the lights is off, it's the man's fault. If the car don't start, it's the man's fault. If ain't no food in the house, it's the man's fault. When God came down, he said, Adam! Why art thou? He said, I hid because I was naked. God said, you've been naked, but who told you you was naked? He said, a woman you gave me. God said, woman, what has you done? She said, a serpent beguiled me, and I did eat.
Yeah.
God went back from the serpent to the woman and to the man. And he told the man, because thou have hearkened to the voice of your wife, death befell on the whole wide world. Through one man's sin, death fell on the entire world. God is looking for a man to stand up and preach the gospel. When I met Stan, I knew I was talking about it last night in my dream, and God said, go over there, tell us who, because Stanley was born to fight.
Yes.
He said, Harold Stanley was born to fight. Like he told Isaiah, I knew you in your mama's womb.
Yes.
We need some bold men in this day and time.
Yes.
It's time out praying with people's souls.
Yes.
It's time out coming up here doing the moonwalk and doing twisting and pulling. He's like, that stuff don't work no more. They done turned the church into an entertainment center. Millions are dying and going to hell. Women's coming around with these tights. They're trying to entice for being provided. It ain't no time. But yes, the Bible say come at y'all. But when you mature, you ought to do mature things. Somebody ought to say amen. You stop rolling your eyes at me before they get locked in your head. Jeremiah said, I'm not going to preach no more. He said, the people was too mean. They face is hard. He said, Lord, you deceived me. He said, I'm going home and I'm not going to preach no more. But something happened when the Holy Ghost was in. He said that the word of the Lord burned in me like fire shut up in my bones. Somebody ought to have some fire this morning. Tell somebody that I'm saved. I'm sanctified. I'm filled with the Holy Ghost. Tell somebody he's good all the time. Turn your Bible to the book of Ephesians. Try to get some water. Yeah, I'm free over here. This is a spiritual church. It's not no good church. This is a spiritual church. I feel, soon as I walked in here, the first time I came for his father's funeral, the Bible says the first thing you look for when you go in the house is look for peace. So you don't find no peace, shake your heels, son. God will lead you in the path of righteousness. Young girl, young man, he ain't going to lead you to sell no crack and break nobody's house. And you are saying in the choir. Young woman, he ain't going to lead you up here saying in the church and then you go do a booty call. He ain't off into that now. The only reason I can preach like this here, because this is a preacher's mouth. Stand and love the truth. I know you ain't gonna like what I'm finna say, but notice here. The Bible says, notice in the last days, perilous times shall come when men shall become lovers of themselves, boasters, high-minded, proud, disobedient, without natural affection, ungodly, unholy, having a form of godliness, but denying the power of hell. I'm glad that some old heads said amen. God said, men who stick in the house are silly with it, laden with sin. Ever learning but never coming to the truth. Put him out. Tell him to go. God will be your hug. God will rock you to sleep. God labor to come see about you. And I'm going to tell you, God loves you, woman. God loves you, young brother. He met the woman in the head, the woman at the well. He said, go call your hood. She said, I ain't got now. He said, you ever told the truth? You told the truth. How the one you had six of, the one you got ain't yours. She was loving too many men. God said, ain't nothing wrong, but give all that love to me. You special in the Lord outside. Watch this here. The only reason I take this medicine and chew this gum, I know protocol, but I've been shot. I got 3 bullets in me when I used to be a crook. Amen. Such was some of you. Amen. Y'all look at me like I came from home. Y'all the Bible says such was some of you. Somebody say amen. Tell somebody, say, he's telling the truth. Let me tell you this, I see some eyes over there. Get what the Bible says. The Bible says you tell a wise man the truth, he'll thank you. The Bible says you tell a fool the truth, he'll get mad and turn on you. Some of us in here ain't nothing but fool. I'm standing and teaching and preaching and people still doing what they want to do. The new girls on the front, they like this. Turn your Bibles to Ephesians. I just preached 3 sermons. Paul preached all night till the boy fell out the window. He preached 18 hours. I'm not gonna let you fall and break your neck. If I can't heal you, then you're gonna be one dead Christian. Amen. All right. All right. It's the truth, Ernie. Turn y'all Bibles to Ephesians, the 6th chapter. Yes, sir. I'm gonna tell you something right quick. I want you to listen at me good. Verse 10. 6 and 10. Finally.
Yes, sir.
Look at the word fine. He said, if you want to, you may be seated. I'm not offering to stand. I know they stood in the Bible. The first time you get to heaven, Jesus is going to say, sit down. Amen. So don't make no difference what you stand or sit to me. But if that's the order of the how, so be it. He said, fine.
Yeah.
Fine, you ought to grow up.
Yeah.
Fine, you ought to stop letting people get next to you.
Yeah.
Finally, you ought to stop writing hot checks, writing hot income tax. Just finally grow up. Tell that man, no, you're not drinking no more. And tell him, get out your house. Finally, you ought to grow up. Turn to somebody and say, well, you ought to grow up. You may be seated. Watch what he's finna say now. And say, finally, my brethren, be strong. Not in your mama. Not in your daddy. Not in Lulu. But God is talking to you, finally, grow up and be strong. Stop letting the devil take advantage of you. Let me say this right quick. Over in the book of Job, the book of Job, first and second chapter, talked about that other day when the Son of God was to present himself before God.
Yeah.
And Satan came also. And the Bible said that Jesus, look, nobody saw him but God. And I'm telling you this, don't forget this. This is the first time that Satan ever told the truth. He told the truth. He was talking to the master.
Yeah.
And God said, wait on. He said, I'm going to and fro. Watch this here. One time to get saved. Somebody going to come up here and get their life to Jesus. I can feel it. Why would the devil do it? God asked the devil, say, where you going? Watch what I'm going to preach on. Where you going? God saw him. He said, I'm going to and fro down in the earth. And I'm looking for anybody that I can destroy. That's what he said. He liked to kill me with these 338s in me. Some of y'all have been cut.
Oh, yeah.
Some of y'all have been stabbed. Some of them go home, drop it. I don't know what, and God got you. No, say amen. Stop it. You got a ball in the car now. The Bible said there's much corruption in the church house. I know you don't want to hear this here, but I'm withstanding this morning. Judgment, y'all think judgment gonna start on the outside. Judgment gonna start right here in the house of God. He's coming back out of church without spot. I'm not praying no grand. Y'all know I'm telling the truth.
Yeah.
The devil, where you going? I don't care who you is. And he used to use us pastors. We would drive people away when they had pants on. In the era when I came up, I was hard against pastors. Satan don't care if they buck naked. He want their soul. And here a self-righteous pastor put people out of the church how they got on a pair of pants. And the devil, every time they put somebody out of the church, the devil say, good job, bro. I know you don't want to say amen. And them old folks were wrong as they could be. The Bible say old folks are not always wise. Get them pregnant girls and put them up here in the front and make them repent and some of them that fooling with Deacon Neil day. I know you don't want to say amen now. I know you don't want to say amen. Put your precious blood up here. God wants to love everything that comes to them doors. Finally, my brother.
Yes.
Be strong
in who?
In the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Watch this right quick.
Come on now.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody say flesh and blood.
Flesh and blood.
But against principalities.
Yeah.
Against powers.
Power.
Watch this here, y'all. Against the rulers of darkness of this world, against, watch this here, spiritual wickedness Watch this, in high places. High places mean the White House, the church house, and everywhere else that there's money, there's a lot of corruption going on. Turn to somebody and say, Pastor, going to talk a few minutes about it. Strap up and bring the fight on.
Amen.
Strap up. You're not talking about a 9mm. You're not talking about an AK-47. Not talking about your little pop blade knife. In order to sustain and be victorious and go forward, you got to strap up. The Bloods and the Crips and the Black Disciples and the Men Need No Warriors always talking about strapping up with their guns. And when they strap up, they kill people. I'm so sick and tired of our young black men killing each other. Every time Joseph and I look at TV, another black brother that got killed, and God, it's time for us to pray for our people. Stop talking about how they wear their pants and let them feel the love of God. You know, church folks, strap up. Put on your helmet. That you can think right.